Okay, let's go.
Hello everyone, my name is Nga from Victory Channel. As we know, online game addiction is become more and more popular, especially in school age. It is considered as a social problem like drug addiction. Therefore, to understand this problem of game addiction as well as the situation of it in this area of universities in Taiwan, where you live and study, let's follow me for more information.
According to Wikipedia, online games refer to one of the internet entertainment applications. Online games are essentially video games, but allow players to engage with other players at the same time. Online gaming addiction is a case of internet addiction defined as an impulse control disorder. In particular, users spend more than 38 hours on playing games a week or more and have at least one manifestation, such as difficulty sleeping or distraction, or decide to be online, and so on. The nature of the game is not bad. However, if playing too much will lead to game addiction, depending on the game and very hard to get out. It's not difficult to see where internet club exist, from the cheat to the link. The students have been able to be all day to playing games without eating and sleeping. Even in many cases, parents have to come to pick them up. Game addiction is like addiction to drugs. It has many unpredictable consequences. Game addicts are always tired, sluggish due to lack of sleep, and bloated clothes. Thirdly, it directly affects many issues of health and psychology students. Game addiction also affects the bones of the spine and the brain. Moreover, many students suffer from psychological illness such as depression because of game addiction. Secondly, playing games costs money and time. Gaming takes a lot of time, so students don't have time to learn and participate in other activities. They cannot earn money. The amount of money by their parents cannot be enough for the games, which leads to lying, stealing money, giving birth to many bad hobbies. For students, addictive games are the salty pathway to academic decline, gradual scores, lack of knowledge, deficits to enter video games.
Chào bạn, mình có thể hỏi bạn một vài câu hỏi liên quan đến game được không?
Vâng, tất nhiên rồi.
Một ngày thì bạn dành bao nhiêu thời gian để chơi game?
Mình thường dành khoảng 10 đến 12 tiếng mỗi ngày cho việc chơi game.
Với cái thời gian khá là dài như vậy thì làm sao bạn có thể sắp xếp được việc học của mình cũng như là việc tham gia vào các hoạt động khác?
Mình thường chơi vào buổi tối và sáng sớm, sau đó thì mình về nghỉ một chút và mình sẽ đi học vào buổi chiều.
Chơi game thì có đắt không và một ngày bạn phải trả bao nhiêu tiền cho việc chơi game của mình?
Cũng khá là đắt, khoảng 4.000 một tiếng và vị chi mỗi ngày thì mình sẽ tốn khoảng 100 đến 150.
Một số tiền khá là lớn. Cảm ơn bạn về những câu trả lời của bạn.
What is the cost of this phenomenon? First of all, students are easily attracted and tempted by new things. It is considered that students do not pay attention to study, being dragged by friends. Another part, because the family and the school do not care and cheat management time learning and activities of their children. When you are a student, learning far from home is another reason why parents can follow you, as well as know your daily life. Sadness and pressure of learning, personal feelings, as well as family problems are also the main cause of online game addiction. One student shared that.
Một tháng trước thì mình có chia tay người yêu ấy, trong cuộc sống đấy thì mình cảm giác như là cuộc sống chẳng có gì hết. Cái giải pháp thế giới ảo mình cảm giác là nó tuyệt vời hơn rất nhiều so với cuộc sống mà mình đang sống.
To solve the problem, what we need to do? We can give our solution such as, in order not to fall into the path of game addiction, every student should be conscious in learning, actively cultivating the team, identifying learning is the main task. Besides, parents need to pay more attention to their children's time, and the school needs to coordinate with their families when they experience unusual symptoms such as frequent fatigue and lack of sleep. Government agencies should have a specific measure to manage and running time of the game, organize many interesting playgrounds for students to participate. In addition to the negative effect of online gaming, we can't deny the benefits which it brings. Playing game allows us to entertain after hours of working and studying, increases creativity and speed of reflection. What is more, many real gamers have earned a lot of money from the game.
So, is your choice right or wrong when you put your hand on the keyboard?
Man up, hurry up, turn it up, let's go!